I'd like to start today with a metaphor that I'll be borrowing from Simon and Evelina from that video that she just mentioned. I want you to imagine the British Library, not just the shelves of books, but a hidden world of conveyor belts and robotic arms quietly moving millions of volumes from deep storage to the reading room, so every request is met fast and seamlessly. That's the kind of system we needed at Love Holidays. Not for books, but for content. As we expand across Europe, our real challenge isn't just translating once, but keeping every localized page up to date automatically every time our English source changes. I'm Matt, and I lead the content engineering team, as Evelina mentioned, that built our own digital conveyor belt to move content between languages. Today, I'll show you how we did it and the impact it's having on our expansion. We'll start with why we need to transform our content architecture to support multiple languages. Then we'll explore the translation system we built, particularly focusing on how we handle complex nested content structures. And finally, we'll look at the real-world impact this has had on our expansion velocity and content operations. This is a story about using Sanity not just as a CMS, but as the foundation for a powerful content pipeline that's helping Love Holidays scale across Europe. It's important to point out that our content model was not really in a shape that would allow for sensible automated translation. Having no concept of language tied to our content models, we had no base to work off of. Fortunately, we had an opportunity that came about that would serve as our catalyst for change. Love Holidays initially started with three distinct markets: Great Britain, Ireland, and Germany. Each had its own dedicated content structure in Sanity, with a strict one-to-one relationship between site configuration and content. Up to this point, we'd handled translation for new markets the traditional way, sending content to an agency and waiting for it to come back. It worked, but it was slow, manual, and extremely pricey. As we set our sights on becoming Europe's most loved online travel agent, this approach wouldn't scale. With Austria as our next target market in 2024, we faced a critical decision: continue duplicating content for each new market, or fundamentally rebuild our content model to be more flexible and efficient. So we chose the latter. We chose to rebuild our content architecture, shifting from a site-based model to a language-based model. While this required more upfront investment, it created the foundation we needed for efficient scaling. Instead of duplicating content for each market, we could now share content across these markets that use the same language, with the ability to override specific elements where needed. This wasn't just about Austria. It was about creating a sustainable model for expansion across all of Europe. The technical transformation involved replacing site references with language fields on documents. We modified our content queries with some admittedly pretty gnarly grok to filter by language instead of site, and created support for primary and secondary locales in site configuration. The site-based approach is still supported for the rare cases where we need one-off pages for particular points of sale. This ultimately allowed us to reuse content across markets sharing the same language. For example, Austria could leverage existing German content with Austrian-specific overrides only where needed for things like currency, local preferences, and market-specific promotions. With our foundation in place, we can now look ahead to building our automated translation pipeline. Like the conveyor system at the British Library that efficiently moves books between storage and readers, our system moves content through translation and back into Sanity automatically. The journey begins when our Sanity webhooks detect changes to English content. These events trigger our translation process, a series of connected services that work together to transform content from one language into another. Our translation requests containing document IDs and target languages are published to Google PubSub topics, which distribute the workload. From there, the system breaks these requests into individual document language pairs that can be processed independently. This parallel processing approach is crucial for both efficiency and resilience. If one translation encounters issues, the others continue unaffected. Each document takes its own path through our digital conveyor system, ultimately arriving back in Sanity as a translated draft. When reviewing, the content team will fix any issues by either updating the DeepL glossaries, which are essentially mappings of English words or phrases into phrases of our own choosing in the other languages, or by reworking the original language source. Since we currently overwrite the entire translation, the content team isn't able to manually edit the resulting translations. And this is something we hope to work on in the coming months. One of our biggest challenges was how to translate complex nested documents without tightly coupling our translation code to specific content models. Sanity documents can have deeply nested structures, arrays, and references, all of which needed thoughtful handling during translation. We tackled this by developing a recursive approach that could handle any document structure without requiring constant updates to our translation code as our content models evolved. Our solution traverses the Sanity document structure recursively, creating maps that track paths to translatable string and portable text fields. The system can be configured to exclude specific fields or paths from translation, giving us fine-grained control while maintaining the automation. What makes this approach powerful is that when our engineering team adds new components or fields to our content models, the translation system automatically processes them without requiring code changes. The system adapts to our ever-evolving content needs rather than constraining them. Portable text, Sanity's rich text format, presented a unique translation challenge. With its mix of text, annotations, marks, and custom blocks, we needed a way to translate the content while preserving its structure. Our initial thought was to extract all the strings, translate them independently, and reinsert them. But we quickly realized that this would strip away the context that translation engines so badly need for good outputs and potentially break the document structure. Our solution was to serialize the portable text into HTML, which DeepL can process contextually, and then serialize the translated HTML back into portable text. Custom block types become custom HTML elements. Annotations were preserved as custom elements with attributes, and the overall document structure remained intact throughout the translation process. This approach preserved both content and context, allowing us to translate even the most complex of rich text fields automatically. And this brings us to our complete content operations pipeline. The complete system creates a closed loop workflow that minimizes manual effort. English content changes trigger automatic translations that appear as drafts in Sanity. Our content team can then review and adjust only where necessary. Throughout this process, translation metadata is maintained through Sanity's localization plugin, creating a traceable connection between original and translated content. This provides visibility and control while automating the repetitive aspects of content localization. I pre-recorded a short demo showcasing the automated translation flow on landing pages. We start with an English language landing page with no translations present, publish the document, which eventually gets picked up by a translation pipeline, which then creates a new German translation, which can be opened side by side with the original, where the content team can then review things like title and body content, which, as we mentioned, consists of nested types, which have all been translated as well. it's important to note that we keep the annotations, as you see, within the content. The system has fundamentally changed how we approach new market launches. Beyond just Austria, we're now able to generate and regenerate hundreds of landing pages and FAQs in minutes rather than weeks. When we need to launch a new market or refresh existing translated content, our digital conveyor system kicks in, automatically processing, translating, and delivering content back to Sanity. The time and cost savings compared to the traditional translation methods are substantial, but the real impact is in our ability to move quickly as the business needs evolve. Having our content team review the translated content ensures that we are keeping quality at the forefront of the process. In closing, we'll just take a quick look at where we are now and where we are headed. Our translation platform is now fully deployed and handling complex document translations for some of our markets. We've created a self-maintaining system that ensures consistent content across all languages while still allowing for human refinement where the nuance matters most. We're now looking ahead to the next evolution of the system. With it being model agnostic, we can start thinking about rolling this out to more document types quickly and with few code changes. As mentioned earlier, we'll want the content team to affect change from the document itself without losing their changes, while remaining cautious of content drift. Finally, we'll want this process to run incrementally so that we only retranslate the fields that have changed, further reducing cost and time. This was a difficult process to get right. We had to think outside the box when considering all of the ways that we could translate our content while maintaining context, all while making sure we're not blindly building out a pipeline that requires constant maintenance when the content model changes. It's taken a good few months to put this together and have it ticking on in the background seamlessly. And then, just as we've rolled this out, Sanity goes and does this. The Sanity Spring Release. If you haven't seen the spring release or heard about it, I'd suggest checking out the awesome video by Evelina and Simeon. It was jam-packed with incredible new features that we at Love Holidays are super excited about and can't wait to get stuck into. What's of particular interest to us are functions and agent actions. The collaboration of these concepts validate what we've been building with our own content pipelines. We're excited to try these out and compare to what we have built. Over time, it makes sense to us for us to use the platform as it will be sure to evolve with expanding opportunity. Our custom solution demonstrates how Sanity serves as a foundation for sophisticated content pipelines. Not just the CMS, but the core infrastructure for intelligent content operations. The conveyor belts and robotic arms of our system may be digital, but their impact is just as tangible as we expand across Europe. Thank you all for your time today. And yeah, I'd be happy to answer any questions about our approach or if anyone has questions about their own content challenges.
Thank you, Matt. Thank you so much for the shout out. I promise, like I said in chat, I didn't ask him to say this. but it's really cool to see this. Obviously, I have been at Love Holidays. I was there when you had more of a kind of point of sale based language model. And now you changed to this whole new model utilizing, you know, DeepL. I feel like it's, I mean, this is such a cool workflow. It looks so simple when you show it, like you're literally just like pressing a button and then there's like shows up. And then it's like, but I'm sure there's been, like I said, it's taken a few months to get here, which it always does, right? You iterate and you try new things. And obviously this has also been all your team work. So like, it's not something that you just, it wasn't like template that you just kind of like imported, right? What's been the biggest challenge? I know we've talked about webhooks and it's not your favorite thing to deal with, for example. Is that like the biggest thing that's been a pain or anything like you can share that like, if someone wanted to do this themselves to like kind of look out for, I guess.
Yeah, I think as far as like a process point of view goes, I think the webhooks are a bit of a pain for us because we kind of spin up long running services that have to handle the requests coming from these webhooks. So that's just more a bit of admin. But in terms of the actual challenges of the process, I think, as I mentioned earlier, the portable text was like really challenging because we had to think about what are the ways that we could format what portable text is in a way that DeepL or any AI really can really understand, like any LLM can understand and properly translate. Because if you just had to pass in the JSON as it is, or as I mentioned, like the individual strings, the LLMs are losing the context of what surrounds that string. So the results just don't make sense. So trying to think outside of the box there and come up with a solution that worked, I think that was definitely the most challenging thing. Yeah.
I feel like it would be so, I mean, I know that you can't just share code because it's basically, it's not public, but it would be super cool if you could maybe open source that one day. I feel like people could really use what you have done and take inspiration from that, like you said, to just keep the structure when it kind of goes outside of obviously your ecosystem and then back, like have that kind of coupled. Maybe it will actually be easier with functions and agent actions and everything. It should actually be easier. But yeah, we do have some questions in the chat. Sorry, I got ahead of myself. I just wanted to talk about the pain of webhooks. But yeah, Graham asks, Chris was first. What does the desk structure look up for the reviewers? Like, what does it look like, I'm assuming?
So we previously had this like very segmented structure by site, so everything was basically placed under individual sites. So we'd have GB, Ireland, Germany, and everything that existed underneath that was only accessible if you were visiting that exact version of our site. With the localization now, it's kind of moved a bit more globally. But in the same concept, instead of having sites, we now have English, German, and whatever else. And we've got then a similar structure beneath that that's got the pages and FAQs and all of that. But now we're talking about a language structure rather than the sites. And then when we load these up, like when we're querying for a landing page, for example, we do some work behind the scenes where we work out, okay, if you're looking at the Austrian site, we know that there's two languages that we currently support. It's either like Austrian German, which we don't really actually have any content for, or the secondary language of the Austrian point of sale is actually just German. So we'll load up that landing page in the German language, which is the one we've moved over from the old German site.
That makes sense. Yeah. We had a couple other questions. Millie has been a hero and also answered some, but I think still going to go through the one that Graham asked. He asked, going through this and talking at the same time is hard. It's like live demoing. Do the content editor have a list of the newly translated drafts coming in awaiting review, or do they expect it to appear as they edit content? And then I think he continued to also say, I was thinking if the translations are coming in async, there must be a bit of a backlog sometimes to review. Is there a place for them to find a to-do list of a translation review, basically?
Yeah, that's a really good question. And it is on our roadmap. At the moment, we're kind of focusing on like huge batches. So we're kind of trying to spin up new markets and new entire sets of landing pages. So we're talking about hundreds and hundreds. I don't think we're at the point where we'll review all of those right now. But when we get to a stable point with those new markets, we're now talking about maybe 10, 20 a day, whatever it might be. And then we're going to look at building either an app or within Sanity, or just having some kind of insight or something that's pulling all the updated translations for the day so that they can go and tick those off. We've already got a bunch of tools on our like Sanity dashboard. Not the new dashboard, our old dashboard in our studio. Where we've got very similar concepts where we've got like the most recently updated things and stuff. So it does sort of form like a natural task list or something like that.